But last year or so, I remember my family and I having a heart-to-heart talk one of those days when I was free at home. And it got to a point where we were sharing feelings, which was a good thing. But what did come out of that was that my two older kids, I have a 17-year-old, 13-year-old boy, and a 20-month baby. The two older ones shared that they did feel the impact of me not being around, which was a big shock to me, because I thought I tried very hard and I did a lot. For example, I don't work on Sundays when it comes to outside engagements. When it comes to TV production, I have no say, right? If you show a Sunday, you should. But outside for extra income, if the company was hiring me to do their family day or they didn't dance or what have you, I'd say no. And there have been companies who have offered to double the price and I said no. And also on top of that, every year I make it a point to go for a big holiday, 2 weeks to a month with my family, so we can really, you know, get together again. But it seems that all that wasn't enough. Mm-hmm. And that really took me by surprise, you know. So that got me and my wife thinking, okay, what can we do? Early this year, I sat the family down and we discussed and I said, look, I can go part-time. I have no qualms earning less money, but what happens then is that we all have less money.
Yeah.
We can't travel like we used to, we always travel business class.
Mm-hmm.
We can't go for the luxurious holidays, we probably have to, you know, Chinatown will be our, a trip to Chinatown or Little India will be our holidays. I pictured a bad picture, I know that it could be that bad, you know. And my kids, they said, Dad, if it means having more time with you, it's a no-brainer. So that being said, got me motivated and said, right, my wife, and said, okay, we're going to head that path then. So one of the things that I wanted to do was to make sure that I didn't do this without thinking finance-wise. Mm-hmm. We've moved from a house to a condo, a small three-room condo.
When did you move?
In April. So the people in the condo are surprised to see me. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're living here? I said, yes, I am. Oh. You like it? Yes, I do. It's a big change in terms of space, but the sweet deal is that I'm debt free. Finally, after 20 years, I have a first New Year's Eve with my family.
Because you're always hosting countdown shows and stuff.
Right. So it's gonna be bizarre. My kids will look at me like, why are you still here? Aren't you supposed to be there in the TV? And it's going to be really nice. In the past, when I do the countdown show, I'll get texts from my wife and my kids and all that, happy new year and all that, but it's not the same, no? By the time I get home, the kids are asleep because it's too late. When I was in school, because I was so poor, I didn't know how poor I was until one time I was in pre-1, we were doing economics. My teacher wanted to do a real-life illustration. So she asked me, come in, how much do you get for your allowance? So I said, oh, I get 40 cents. Then I realized how wrong it was when the teacher said, okay, come in, come sit down. Then she asked somebody in front, how much you get per day? $2. Another one, $5. And then my friends would always say, hey, after school, let's go to McDonald's and have 40 cents come buy you even the chili packet. So I said, no, I can't go. I make up an excuse, I'm going to do this and that. And I would starve myself so that by end of by Friday, I have $2. And $2 I could be able to buy a filet of fish.
So that you could hang out with your friends.
So when I got this job and I started making money, every country that I go to, I will eat a filet of fish. Even in Singapore, when I go to a filet of fish, I stare at a filet of fish now. And I thank God I said, you know, this is what I couldn't have, except on Fridays. I'm very glad to say that quite a few, actually. I've done my musicals, I've done my live shows, I've done my drama, my comedy. I even had a comedy album out. Got a lot of support, got a lot of good response, like PCK. I'm not trying to brag, but even for me, I think it's quite a phenomenon that it went to do so much that even we didn't think, you know, we knew it was quite funny. but not that funny. You know, like, what the heck is going on? He had his face planted, posted on the tail wing of an airplane that was flying between Singapore and Hong Kong to promote the musical in Dorsey. So the tarmac with the airplane behind me, and I could just imagine the passengers going up, what the heck is this? What airline is this? What am I going on this guy with a mole? And it's funny because when we first came out, we almost didn't make it because we didn't have any sponsors. Nobody would support our show because it wasn't a good association. Which company wanted to associate a product with a English-speaking contractor who tried to con his clients to get extra materials from his own house, for his own house. So the first season, we were in the red. We didn't make any money at all. But because we submitted our tapes to Asian Television Awards, then we won the best actor, actress, supporting actor, supporting actress, and best sitcom, of course. And that was the year we beat Under One Roof. They had been winning all those for the past 3 years, or so, or more. So we were like a new kid on the block that toppled this king that nobody thought could be, nothing funny would come along. And to me, it was a bittersweet thing because originally I was supposed to be Under One Roof. I guess I want to put it for the record that I want to thank my family for the past 20 years. Like, I thank my cast, supporting cast for basically for wasting their life for 20 years. I want to thank my family for wasting their life for 20 years with me. And now I'm going to do all I can to pay back. I mean, what's lost is lost. There's nothing I can do about that. But I hope to make new memories, you know, and so that when I finally leave this place, you know, my kids can tell their children, you know, that, you know, Grandpa, you know, he wasn't around for a while. But after that, he was. And same goes for my wife.